Okay, so now we're at a point with this project where the drawings are ready to send off, but now we got to publish them to a PDF. So this next video, we're going to go through the process of doing that and get these emailed to our customer. Hopefully we get them approved and we can proceed with production. So let's get into our next lesson of training. Okay, so now after one final review of the drawings in model space, now let's select the cover sheet and make sure that we have all this project information looking correct. You can see we've updated our title block information. If there's anything that we need to change, like the site address, can't leave it like that. So let's go back into project properties, put something in here. Okay, so when we go back and update our title block, we can see that change. Make sure our plan view is looking good. Just kind of going through different sheets that we've already laid out here. If there is an additional sheet that you want to add, what you can do is select your layout, SHO2, right click, and here you can move or copy the selected layouts. Just make sure you check that box if you want to create a copy, and you can move it to the end, or you can insert it before that selected layout. There we got a copy. Just double click if you wanted to rename it something. Hit escape to clear that. Right click again, delete it. We don't need it. And another trick I wanted to show you, so you don't need to go through that process, is just hold down control and then make sure you have it selected. Move over with your mouse and drop it into place. Okay, and there's a little shortcut on copying a layout. But after all that, I don't even really need this. So, and now for the cross sections, make sure everything looks good in here. Double check our room properties to see if that's been updated with all the current room information. Right click in this open space and update database. So this is going to update it with all the current database information for this room. Right click in there again, and you see this refresh from template. What that'll do is bring everything in from your library. So if there's anything that you added into this room, it would be overwritten from what's in your template. Now, if we were to add any room level properties here, it wouldn't show up unless those attributes were on our title blocks. So be sure to check out our videos on title blocks and working with our project and room properties. For now, just save and close, and we can go back into our layouts. So I showed you how we can update this view label just by editing the text. But to automate that process, I want to show you something else that we can do. Now, what we're going to do to this view label is only going to be for this one here. So if we like it, we could copy it and just paste it into other locations throughout our drawing. But remember, this is going to be in paper space. So follow along and I'll show you how we can automate updating that scale in this view label. So we're going to type in ET again to open up our edit attribute window. Highlight the text, right click, and insert field. Make sure your field category is selected to objects. Now select object. And now select this button here to go back into the drawing and select an object. So what we're going to do is we're going to select this viewport. And then that viewport has properties. So now we can select a property. The property we're going to select is going to be the standard scale. Format, you can see we have different formats, just keep it as none. Hit OK. And now that's a field. So when we update the drawing inside of that viewport, the property of it's going to change. Hit OK. Let's activate that viewport. Make sure it's unlocked if you want to change the scale. We'll change it to 3/4. And you do have to go back into paper space because that's where the view label is. Hit RE for regen. And there we got our new scale. So that's a really great way just to make sure that you're not accidentally missing something if you were to update your drawing, change the scale, and forgot to edit the text in that view label. Like I said, if you liked it, just delete that one and we can copy this one in place of it. And now into our last few sheets here, we're going to skip the VBase sheet for now, just in our 3D. So we have the settings for this layout coming in from our template as the isometric view. And with a different visual style. Let's change it back to a 2D wireframe to make it a little bit easier to move around and get it into the right position. Okay, that looks good. Now back to a conceptual. Now, if we don't want to see this wall, we can freeze our 3D wall layer in this viewport. So there you can freeze the 3D wall layer. And if there was anything else in this viewport, any other layers that you wanted to freeze, you can go back into that list or a shortcut in the command line, type in lay FRZ and select any other objects. Got our 3D door, got that 3D hardware. And if you wanted to turn it back on, just going back into your list of layers, there you can just turn it back on. Okay, now we're going to go back to the cover sheet, update our title block again, and bring in some of that new project information. Yeah, we're going to want all these to take precedence. There it is on our cover sheet. Let's get these drawings printed out and ready to send off to the customer. I got my cover sheet selected. I'm just going to hold down shift and now select the 3D. Now I got all my sheets selected. If you wanted to, you can also just print out one sheet at a time. So just by the plot button, which is available when only one layout is selected, brings up our plot window. We're going to do the entire set of drawings. So publish to selected layouts. And here we have some of the publish settings. So first you want to make sure that you're publishing to a PDF. PDF preset, also make sure is set to DWG to PDF. Publish options, this is the path to the saved file location. Automatically load all the open drawings into the PDF, make sure that's checked. And publish in background, I typically like to have unchecked. If you had it checked, what you can do is continue working in Toolbox and then you'll be notified when your publishing job is complete. But this way, we're just gonna hit the publish button, pick where you wanna save it. It's opening up that window because of our publishing options. And now, printing to PDF. And as long as you have it set up that way, you get one PDF with all the pages included. Now we email those off to the customer, sit back and wait for the approval. All right, so that wraps up another training lesson in Toolbox. Thanks again for joining me and can't wait to see you on the next one.